This is the student's e-portfolio. Here you can see the student profile page with the work done by the student. Also, in this profile, the digital competence will be shown in the future. This is the manager page, where the student can list and manage his work and his assignment, and also access to the work of his school or the educational community. For the crisis scenarios task, teacher will ask to the students create a history. This button over here. Why? Because the history is completely integrated in the portfolio. The creation of histories allows to the student to include any type of content in a single evidence, from websites, from PowerPoint, files from his drive, a Prezi presentation, any kind of multimedia content can be used. And through the history integrate in his portfolio so that the teacher can review and evaluate. I'm going to create a history. Ecosystems. And assign it to a group class. Here I have my history. And I can upload anything to my history. I click here on upload button and I have access to my library with all my contents. I can also upload any documents from my computer, tablet, iPad, smartphone, etc. I can choose one or a whole group of files and upload them in my library. I can use an embed. Take a Prezi, a SlideShare, or anything with an embed code. In another window of my Explorer, I've looked up a Prezi about ecosystems. A Prezi is a kind of PowerPoint, like a presentation. I click on the button of Insert and I get a code that I can copy. I get back to my history and paste the code. I write a title, a description, etc. So then I have my Prezi included in my history. Let's see what else can be included. I can enclose a link. For example, I go to the wiki and I copy the page address and paste it in my history with a description, etc. Also, I can put tags. And when I click there, the wiki page opens. This way, I can explain and show my different tasks in a single evidence and organize my evidence into my e-portfolio. I can choose an image by default for my history, a cover. If I go to my e-portfolio, you'll see that the image is there and automatically linked to my history. Let's go out to my history and see what else can be included. I go to my drive and I can search and select one image. Now it's in my library and I can select it to include in my history. If I want to upload a drive which is shared by several people and I want to keep on editing, for example, I have one here, is the last revision of the document CRISP platform design. So, if I want to keep on editing the drive document, I don't want to import in the portfolio. I want to import only the address to the document into the drive. I copy it and then I go to the library and choose to include a link. So I take the link, put the name and description, etc. The sync of the CRISP platform. This is the final sync of the different tools. And now I have it on my history. I'm going to preview my history. So when I click here, it takes my two Google Docs And I can continue editing the document. What else? Okay, this one I'm going to delete. I'm going to upload more contents. Ah, YouTube. Let's look for one of digital competence. I select this one and the other one that seems interesting. Automatically the videos are added to my history. What else I can upload? The same as with YouTube, I can take Vimeo, Sketchfab, the 3D contents, and you can see it here. So, in the creation of the task for the scenarios, we have to ask our students to create a history, because this is how he can share any sort of work. Both when it's something he did on his device, computer, tablet, iPad, smartphone, etc., and he uploads it, or with an embed or content from his drive, etc. This way the history is integrated in the portfolio and also inside the realization of the scenario that I ask my student. Now I'm entering as a teacher. Before I was entering as a student, Eva. You'll see what happens. Like a teacher, I go to my manager. Here I can see the tasks done by my students, the work done by Eva on ecosystems. I click on it, and then it takes me to the Eva evidences. Of course, even if the work is in private mode, I can see it as a her teacher. I can review all the contents, the videos, the Prezi, the 3D, the Sketchfab, etc. Here in my manager, I have all my students' works. So, this is to get a first idea of how the portfolio works. The Crisi portfolio is, of course, still under development, and the final version will not be exactly the same, but because we have under construction all the time. But the structure of the student presenting his work through the history and the way the teacher can access and evaluate it will be like this.